Hi everyone, I'm Nathan Hode, and in this video I'm going to talk about how I made this settings menu for my Godot game. Let's get right into it. This pause menu is composed of a color rect background with a blur shader and my menu component that I've talked about before. Long story short, it's a VBox container with some smarts about moving a pointer around to match the current selection and knowing when an item has been actioned. It also has some stuff in there to auto-disable certain child nodes from being selectable if their name contains the word heading. When an item is actioned, the menu emits an actioned signal that contains the index of the item and the node for that item. From there, I can check against the node name and do something based on which item was actioned. For example, here we can resume the game, open the settings menu, or quit. When we choose settings, we get another menu. This one works mostly the same as any other menu, with the addition of pressing left and right to adjust slider values. This works by listening for another couple of signals from the menu. Actioned left is emitted when an item contains the word slider and the player presses left. Actioned right is emitted when an item contains the word slider and the player presses right. The volume values are then fed into my settings global, which handles saving them and passing them onto the actual sound manager. The sound manager I'm using is my own add-on, which you can grab a copy of from GitHub. A link to it is in the description. This settings global also handles loading settings and initializing them when the game starts. Back in our settings menu, you'll see that we have options for gamepad controls and keyboard controls. In gamepad controls, we can remap our input. A player can press the action button to change one, then press the new button to set it. If the new button clashes with an old one, then I just swap them. The keyboard controls menu works pretty much the same way, but for the keyboard. Most of the heavy lifting here is being done by my input helper add-on. A link to that is in the description too. Input Helper provides a few methods that make input remapping a bit easier. For gamepads, there is Set Action Button and Get Action Button. Get Action Button will return the button index for a given action. Set Action Button will change the button index for a given action to be whatever you give it. If you pass true to this third argument and it finds a clash when setting the new button index, it will set the clashing action to be whatever the one you're setting used to be. So, if I set inventory to be A, it will swap the accept button because they can't both be A. Remapping the keyboard is very similar. The only difference is we have get action key and set action key, which takes a string argument instead of the numbered index. The string is the result of an input event key calling as text. And that's about it. As always, if you have any questions, then add a comment below or jump into my Discord and have a chat. I'll see you there, or I'll see you here again soon. Bye.